Hi guys, it's Angie with Fun Endeavors Tie-Dye Lab. Today, I'm going to make some ice-dyed geode pillowcases. I washed and dried the pillowcases, soaked them in a soda ash solution for 20 to 30 minutes, then I wrung them out in my pan to spin dryer so they're just barely damp. I'm going to do two different kinds of pillowcases today. I'm going to do two throw pillows and two king-size pillow shams. I'm starting with the throw pillows, and I'm going to begin by unzipping them. Then I want to find a spot on the pillow where I'd like for the center of a geode to be. Grab that part with one hand, and then using my other hand, I'm going to slide it down to where I'd like the bottom of that geode to be. That's where I'm going to start tying the sinew. I personally like to tie my geodes starting from the bottom and going out to the end or to the top. I think it gives it more of an organic feel, and they tend to look less like a bullseye and more like a geode shape for me. I also like my geodes to look a little bit more organic, so I vary the sizes of them and the amount of lines that I put in them with the sinew. Since I'm tying with the sinew, every place where I put a sinew line and I pull it tight is going to remain white underneath that area after I apply the dye. The wax coating won't allow the dye to get under that area. I'm going to repeat this same process a couple more times on this throw pillow. I'm making the geodes pretty large, so I'm not going to be able to get a whole lot on each one of these pillows. I'm being gentle around the zipper so that I don't break the zipper when I'm tying it with sinew. I'm going to do the same process on the second throw pillow, but I don't want them to be exactly the same, so I'm only going to make three geodes on that pillow instead of four. The next two pillows are king-size pillow shams, so there's quite a bit of fabric to work with these. By the way, all of these pillowcases are 100% cotton, and I purchased them all from Amazon. You'll find links down below this video in the description for the exact pillowcases and shams that I purchased. I'm basically going to do the same process that I did when I tied the geodes onto the pillowcases. I'm trying to only grab one layer of the fabric on the pillow sham though when I begin tying. So I'm not tying the front and the back at the same time when I grab a place where I'd like to begin a geode. Since I have a bit more fabric to work with, some of the geodes are larger or fatter than others, and some of them are bigger than others, but that's intentional. Like I said, I'd like for it to look as organic and random as possible. Once I have all the geodes tied, I'm going to put the pillowcases aside and let them dry out completely. I personally like to dye geodes when they're completely dry since they're such a thick fold. I feel like I get much better color saturation into the middle of the geode. I actually got busy and these sat for probably about 2 or 3 weeks before I got to dyeing them. Since I want these four shams to look fairly similar, I decided to go ahead and just dye them in the muck in the same container. So I've placed them down inside of a plastic container, and I've tried to make them as flat as possible. I'm going to begin by randomly applying the dye to the top of the geodes. I'm starting with Brazil Nut from Dharma Trading Company. A few of the geodes are kind of hidden underneath another one, so I'm trying to apply a little bit of dye to those areas as well. I know that quite a bit of the dye is falling off into the container, but it's just going to become part of the muck and add to the design. The next color I'm using is Mocha from Pro Chemical and Dye. I'm not going to cover up every little white area on the geodes, partially because they're odd shaped and so some of the dye is just going to fall off anyway. And because some of those areas will fill in later. I also don't want everything to be colored. On these geodes, I don't mind if there's a little bit of white left. Now I'm using Burgundy from Dharma Trading Company. I want there to be quite a bit of burgundy on these geodes, so I'm adding a lot more of this color than I did the others. Most of the time, I try to find a geode in nature that has the coloring that I prefer or that I find interesting, and choose dye colors that come close to mimicking that geode. However, this time I was trying to match a specific color palette, so I chose the colors according to that color palette. Now I'm applying a little bit of extra soda ash to the top. I want to make sure that I have plenty of soda ash left after I add quite a bit of ice to the top. Because these are such thick folds, I want to make sure that I have plenty of muck for the pillowcases to sit all the way down in the muck. So I'm adding quite a bit of ice to the top. Over the top of the ice, I'm going to add vanilla bean from Pro Chemical & Dye. This will help fill in some of those white areas that I left on top. And it will also just add a little added dimension to the geodes. The final color that I'm going to add is Ecru from Dharma Trading Company. I really like the Ecru on geodes, so I'm adding quite a bit of that to the top of the ice. Here again, that'll fill in some of those white areas that I left. Now I'm going to set the container aside and not touch it or disturb it at all for 24 to 48 hours. Then I'm going to take the pillowcases to my sink and begin rinsing. I begin rinsing in cold water, and that will rinse out any of the excess soda ash that's remaining inside the pillowcases. Then I gradually warm the water up to hot. The hot water helps to rinse out any of the excess dye that didn't react with the pillowcase. After I rinse them really well, I put them in the washing machine along with a little bit of Dharma's textile detergent. I washed them in hot water, put them in the dryer, and this is what they look like. Okay, so I really like the way these pillows turned out. I ended up with a lot of interesting color splits from the burgundy, Brazil nut, and the mocha. There are various shades of brown and khaki and olive, even a little bit of gray. On one of them I found a slight tinge of yellow. I think that probably came from the vanilla bean. The vanilla bean and the ecru did really well to fill in some of the white spots, and all the colors work really well together, I think. I did end up with some white left on the pillows, which I was expecting, and I think it works with the design. I used some of the solid color pillows to kind of break up or separate the geode pillows. I found that it showcased the pillows a little bit more if I didn't have them sitting on top of one another. They kind of blended in a little bit too much when I did that. This way, they're separated and you can see all of the different geodes and the pattern and design a little bit better. So if you guys have enjoyed watching this video, I sure would appreciate it if you'd hit the big red subscribe button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you have a great day.